The Cub Weekender. It's one of our most popular models and has been for a long time. It's so light, it can be easily towed by any small to medium car. If you're looking for a camper that's perfectly set up for quick weekends away or some of those longer trips, but still light, the Weekender is the one for you. The Weekender is a super comfortable camper trailer. Fitted with your double bed here, you've got underbed storage. And of course, you've got the 2.2 metre hard floor area if you wanted to get out of inclement weather and sit down in here with a table and chairs and read a book. The standard fitment on the Weekender in regards to power. Now it comes with a 35 amp hour battery, two USB outlets at the side of the bed, two 12 volt outlets down near the foot of the bed. And there's also an internal double 240 outlet with an inlet on the outside of the camper. So if you're at a powered site, you've always got ample supply of mains power. And don't forget the floor lighting as well. Now, being all Australian made, the tent is made from Wax Converters canvas. Now that's made up in the Hunter Valley. And as you can see, there's six windows. Now they're quite large, so you've got heaps of ventilation. Now, while you're out and about on your travels, you're going to make good use of the kitchen. Now, the Weekender is fitted with a two burner stove. And here you've got the sink with a flick mixer tap connected to the 12 volt water pump, in turn connected to the 60 litre water tank. Now, it's all stainless steel, all made in-house by Cub. Now the kitchen also comes with this really handy stainless steel wind guard. Just stops some of those breezes that might affect your cooking. Now on the front edge of the kitchen here, there are two drawers. Now these are really handy for your kitchen implements and cutlery, some plates and cups, etc. Now every good kitchen has a pantry, and we don't leave the Weekender out on that respect. Up here at the pointy end on the Weekender, okay, this is where you'll find the hitch. The Weekender has a mechanical override brake system, so that means you don't need to fit out your car with electric brakes. And if you wanted to lend your camper to family members, easy to do that. There is a handbrake attached to it as well, jockey wheel. There's a rated safety chain and also 12 volt wiring for your lights, your indicators, brake lights, etc. Now behind that, there's a 4 kilo gas bottle in a holder. Now that's plumbed through to here, and there's a regulator hiding behind the regulator shroud here. On top of the winch post is the winch. Now that's part of Cub's Ezy-wind system, and that's one of the reasons why this camper is so easy to open and close and set up. The Weekender has a nice long drawbar. Now in days gone by, it used to be an option to fit the transcontinental pack. Now this comes standard with the Weekenders these days, but what it also gives you is this area here. Now you can customize the Weekender. You can put a half size fridge box on here or a toolbox. Now it's really up to you what you want to do. Now previously when I was inside the Weekender, I was talking to you about the power that comes with this particular camper. Now behind the locker door here, you'll see that there's the remote display for the 240 volt charger. Below that, 12 volt fuses. Now they're for your 12 volt outlets and USB outlets, etc. Next to it is the 240 volt safety switch. Locking water filler cap. The Weekender gets around on Alco 4 leaf shackle springs.